Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's take a look at the Mac Dictionary app. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when it comes to the dictionary app on your Mac, there are some users that don't know it's there and others that take it for granted. It has a lot of different functionality. Let's launch it by using Spotlight. I'm going to do Command Space and search for dictionary. Just the first couple letters is all I need and I can launch it that way. I can use Launchpad. I could drag it to the left side of the dock to make it a little more easily accessible if I want to. Now the basics are pretty simple. To look up a word, you just type it here in the search field at the top. And then you get a definition. Now you should see here a list of dictionaries that you have enabled. So you have the regular dictionary, which will give you a definition. You probably see some others here as well. Of the particular use is the thesaurus or synonym finder. So you could search for a word and then go to that and then get different synonyms for it. Now whether you're looking at dictionary definitions or in the thesaurus, you can click on most things in here. So if you see a word, you can click on it and it will go to the entry for that. You can switch between dictionaries and keep the same word. Now what about these other dictionaries here? You may see Apple and Wikipedia. Apple is particularly useful if you want to look up a tech term. So you can look it up in the dictionary, but clicking on Apple will give you a definition from a custom Apple dictionary. It's very useful for looking up things that have to do with Apple computers and devices. So for instance, if you hear some term and you're not sure what it is, you can look it up here and find out that definition according to Apple. Now Wikipedia is really useful because this can search the entire Wikipedia site. So instead of going to wikipedia.org to search Wikipedia, you can do it right here in the dictionary app. It's actually pulling these definitions live from Wikipedia. So you're getting the most up-to-date versions, not something stored on your computer. So you can view more than one dictionary source at a time by selecting all. Then you're going to see things like dictionary, thesaurus, Wikipedia, and anything you've got here. It's all just going to be in a big list. Now you can set which dictionaries you've got by going to Dictionary Preferences, which is basically just a big list of dictionaries. You're going to have a lot of these that come installed on your Mac. And the one that you have selected at the beginning depends on your country. So here in the US, I've got the New Oxford American Dictionary for American English. But there are other ones that are available as well. Notice that when I select some of these, there are options. For instance, I can choose the type of pronunciation marks shown in the definition here for the American Dictionary. For Wikipedia, I can select language. But most of these will just simply have copyright information there. If you want to add another dictionary, you can just select it and you can see it gets added here. Here's now that dictionary as well. The order here is important. You can drag and drop any one of these to change the order. So now I've switched Wikipedia and Apple. When you select all, you're going to get them in the order that they appear here. So put your most important source first. So let's look at some more functionality here in the app window. You can change the font size. If it's too small for you to read, you can make it larger and you can also make it smaller. There's also forward and backward buttons just like in a web browser. So you can go back to the previous definition after exploring a new one. You also can open up links in new tabs or windows. So for instance, I can control click here and you could see I could select look up in new tab or window. So new tab will give you a tab just like browser tabs or tabs in any other app. Or I could control click and select new window and you can have multiple dictionary windows open. You control these tabs just like tabs in any other app. So I can move them around, I can close them, and I can even go to file and start a new window or new tab without actually clicking on another word. I also have a plus button here to open up even more tabs. Now if you don't understand these cryptic little pronunciation guides here, you also can have your Mac speak the word to you. Now you'd think since it's a computer generated voice and all that it might mispronounce some things, but it's actually pretty good. I looked up some of the most commonly mispronounced words and it gets them right. So in order to have it pronounce something, you can't really click here because it breaks it up into syllables. But usually you could find the word somewhere here in the definition or in an example phrase or something. Control click on it, choose speech and start speaking.
Covered.
And as you can see, it actually pronounced that one right. This one, it gets right as well.
Epitome.
And even this one.
Imprimatur.
So it looks like the pronunciations can be pretty trusted. Now there are several other ways to access the dictionary without even opening the dictionary app. One is to simply look up a word. So you can select a word and then control click on it and select Look Up. And you're going to get this window that gives you the dictionary definition. This is from the dictionary app, but it appears in a separate window. You can click on links here at the bottom to open this up in the dictionary app. You can even switch dictionaries here at the bottom. Now you can also use a keyboard shortcut, Control, Command, and D, with your cursor hovering over something. It doesn't need to be selected. And that will also bring up the same thing. There's a further keyboard shortcut. If you go into System Preferences and then go to Keyboard, Shortcuts, you look under Services, and then you look at the category called Searching. There's Lookup in Dictionary, and you can add a shortcut. Let's add Control, Option, Command, and D as a shortcut for this. Now when I select a word, I can try to use this. It also appears under the Application menu, Services, Searching. This will actually go right to the dictionary app, so it's different than the standard lookup shortcut, which opens up that special window. Now you can also use Spotlight to look up words. So Command Space to bring up Spotlight. Now you can just use the word and it should look it up, give you a definition here, and you can see this is the definition from the dictionary app. If you double click on it here, it will actually open up the dictionary app right to that word. Now one problem with using dictionaries to figure out how words are spelled is that sometimes you can't look it up because you don't know how the word's spelled, right? So you can use Siri for this. So just ask Siri and it will give you a dictionary definition. Siri, how do you spell phlegm?
Phlegm. P-H-L-E.
So you can see there, I can get a definition by just speaking the word. Unfortunately, that doesn't link to the dictionary, even though the data is obviously taken from the dictionary. So a few other tips here. If you remember when we had actual physical dictionaries, you'd also remember that at the beginning of the dictionary and the end of the dictionary, there was all this additional information, things about languages and history and all sorts of things. You actually have that with some of the dictionaries here. So here I have the dictionary selected. I'm using the new Oxford American Dictionary. If I do go, front matter, back matter, it actually takes me to a list of all of this information from that dictionary. So I can jump to things like the key to pronunciations, for instance, or the history of English. Not all dictionaries are going to have this, so you're not going to be able to see this for everything here. Now if you want to add more dictionaries to the list here, you can. It will use any standard dictionary file. They're also known as .dict files or sometimes .dictionary files. And you can actually find them online and add them. Now they're kind of difficult to find and sometimes you find ones that just don't work because there are other formats as well that call themselves dictionary formats. But if you do find one, the way to add it is to go to File and then Open Dictionaries folder. And this will open up the Home folder, Library Dictionaries folder. And you can add new dictionaries in here. So for instance here I've got one that translates from English to Esperanto. Now I'm going to quit the dictionary app and run it again. And now when I go to Preferences, I should be able to find that in here. And there it is all the way at the bottom. I'll select that and now you can see it in here. So now I can look up a word and go to this translation dictionary and get a translation there. A lot of the dictionaries that you get by default here are actually translation dictionaries. And one last tip I want to show you, though I won't demonstrate it, is if you go to System Preferences, Screen Time, and then you go to Content and Privacy, and you turn on Content and Privacy Restrictions, there is an option here for explicit language in Siri and dictionary. So that'll eliminate some words from the dictionary that are considered explicit, cleaning your dictionary up a bit. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.